Yeah.
Is this a better time for that talk?
What talk, dude? What do you want now?
Yeah, I think I understood.
It's just, I was ready to give up. I didn't care if I lived or died anymore. At least not for myself. And it was because of you and who you are that turned things around for me. I just wanted to make sure you knew that.
Yep, got it. We're all good. Romance. Preston, are you trying to hit on me? Because I thought we went through this already. Like, you're an okay guy. You annoy the shit out of me sometimes, but, you know, I don't like you like that. You know, I'm a straight player. That's what I am.
I'm glad you decided to stick around, Preston. The world needs more people like you.
Well, now you're making me embarrassed. I hope I didn't make you too uncomfortable telling you all that. I just felt like it needed to be said, you know? I guess we should get back to it, huh?
Yeah, why are you even talking to me? You're not my partner right now. Mr. Dance here is.
Hey.
Awaiting your command.
I guess Preston's just gonna do that every now and then.
Wanna swap some gear?
Anyway, guys, so yeah, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 4. This video is going up a couple days later than I wanted it to. And to make a long story short, well, this is the first time I've recorded Fallout since my move across the country. And it turns out that I needed some equipment to do this correctly. Where are we at on here? We had a mission for that crazy guy, Barney. Now I'm not sure where it is. Let's just see if we can fast travel straight back there. But yeah, so it turns out that my setup here is a little bit different than it was back at my old place. Activate Barney's turrets, that's what we wanted. Let's go straight there. Into Salem. Because I'm actually using a computer monitor now. Back then, I only used my TV for everything, like even like general computer work, which I know sounds weird, but that's just how it was. And now that I have a monitor and TV set up, I had to go get an audio splitter cable and figure out some other things. Like I said, it's kind of a technical nightmare, but I think I have everything set up the way I want, and I don't think we'll have any problems. I'm only gonna do like a short recording now, like short for Fallout 4. I'm gonna do like a half hour. Hopefully, and then see how it turned out. I think we'll be okay. There's a level 26 Mire Lurk. Get out of here, bitch. But yeah. I know that I probably always sound like a broken record when I do this game because I'm always saying the same shit. Like, oh, it's been a while since we played. I had tactical problems. I forget what I'm doing. I have no idea what's going on. That's just my life, guys. That's the way the long couch gets down. Taking that nuclear material. Who's this, bro? Raider survivalist.
Where'd they go?
He didn't survive that. I'll tell you that much. All these dudes are getting like melted. It's awesome. This appears to be some sort of churchy area. Burnt textbook, 8-ball. Go ahead and grab this wine. One thing I do remember is that I came to this area because I just wanted to take a short break from the railroad stuff and go check out that Museum of Witchcraft because we got that quest like 6 years ago and I wanted to finally check it out. And now we're setting up stuff for that crazy old guy. I love the random shit you find in this game. Okay, property of the Salem Volunteer Militia, authorized personnel only. Let's first check out... Wait, can we do the turrets without entering the password? That's weird. I guess we actually want to turn these on, right? But we only have the choice to deactivate them. Let's put in the password. Activate turret. Okay. So it's just a simple matter of choosing that option and turning them on. And they shouldn't attack us, right? Barney's turret, level 6. It's friendly. Once again, I have to do the broken record thing and apologize to you guys for having so long between videos. I never intend for it. Like I said, this would have been up a few days ago, but I ran into those problems. Luckily, it was a relatively easy fix, though. I just had to drop like $7 on an audio splitter cable. The harder part was actually figuring out how to configure it. It's really weird because my capture card is installed in the computer that I play games on, and they're not really meant to do that. Like, you can do it, it just takes some technical finagling. What the hell is that noise down there? Something's crawling this way. That dude's alive. Oh shit, there's the other one. Dude, there's one right here! For some reason he wasn't coming at me. Oh shit! I think that if you kill them with a Molotov, it should automatically be roasted Mirelurk. That should just be what goes in your inventory. This shit is super roasted. Look at that. That's not even edible anymore. But I'll eat it. Alright, what do we got here? Ooh, a fat man! Don't really need it, but I'll grab it. Lots more food. We'll take all the cans too, they're good for scrap. What? Okay, look at this. We've got a bowling pin and a league bowling pin. Why in the world would they actually make a separate entry for that? Like, what difference could there possibly be in those? That's kind of funny. Two out of five. You know, speaking of well-done meat, I want your guys' opinion on something. I actually got in an argument the other day with somebody because I was getting a burger at Red Robin, right? And when they asked me how I wanted it done, I said, well done, because it's a freaking burger, like a bacon cheeseburger, right? And I got yelled at and told that you should never make meat well done. It's always supposed to be like, you know, rare or medium rare or something. And I always thought, like, I agree with that as far as steaks go. Like, a well-done steak is kind of gross. I know some people like them. But when it comes to burger, I mean, that's a whole different beast. It's a different consistency. It's a different type of meat. I thought that dude was nuts, but he said I'm the one who's nuts. So I don't know. Oh shit, that dude went flying. So yeah, what's your opinion on burger meat and how well it should be cooked? I actually want to know. I want to get, like, opinions on that. Let's see. One thing that's pissing me off, though. Let's look at our perk chart. If I remember correctly, I bought the Mysterious Stranger. Yeah, we have the first rank of it. He's supposed to show up in vats and help us out, but I haven't seen him even one time. So hopefully that happens in this video, because I've really wanted to, like, not only, like, see it for myself, but show it off to you guys. And it's, you know, being a real bitch about it. Okay, the next one is up there. I don't know how the hell we get up there. I'm probably gonna save some of this rifle ammo, though, because these enemies around here aren't super difficult. Okay, looks like we gotta come up over here. There's a bunch of enemies up there.
We may have a problem.
Mirelurk kill claw. That might be the first time I've seen that.
That's how we do it in the Brotherhood.
He still went down like a bitch, though. It also occurs to me that using the Deliverer in vats offers more shots, and therefore more chances for the Mysterious Stranger to show up. That's my logic, anyway. Alright, what do we got up here? Nothing. Dance is still fighting. I hope we get a cool reward for this. That crazy Barney guy, I don't know. He seems alright. But you never know with crazy people. Oh god, five shots and no stranger. What is his, like, chance to pop? Is it, like, 1%? Because, damn. I mean, I'll probably go for the second level of that with the next upgrade point I get. I'm not sure how far away that is. What? Oh, shit. Oh, it's a bunch of little guys. Hold up. One. Oh, why didn't you do the second one? Oh, there it did. It was just a weird angle. It actually went to first person for it. I so rarely aim for more than one target in VATS, I guess I'm not used to that. Alright, take all the eggs. Take the cram. And we'll take the bottle cap mine, of course. Alright, 4 out of 5. Last one is gonna be... Looks like there's actually two of them right on the roof over there. You guys see that? Interesting. But yeah, I'm not sure how many of you guys watch like every video I put up, or if you only watch this series. I mean, I said this in my Uncharted 4 series, because I did post a couple videos of those, you know, after I got out here, but in case you didn't catch it, I want to say one more time, thanks so much for the support and all the kind words and comments on my blog video about, you know, my life situation with the move and everything. Every single person who replied and commented on that video was just like super nice and, you know, wished me well and was so friendly, and I really appreciate it. Like, I love all you guys. And I won't go crazy with that kind of talk, but I just wanted to put that out there. Thank you so much. We have to get on this roof somehow. I don't really see any access points. There's like a tower right there. Could maybe climb up on there. That's not really gonna lead anywhere. Okay, there's gotta be like an inner stairwell. There's a balcony up there. Ah, here we go. This appears to be somebody's dwelling. I'm gonna go ahead and quick save. I'm about to steal this kid's toys, because I don't have any toys of my own. Whoops, I didn't mean to take the farmhand clothes, but whatever. I was half expecting to run into somebody up here. Oh, I wonder if this guy is the dweller. 17 caps hidden under the stairs. Did anybody else just get, like, motion sickness? I didn't, but I imagine that if you're prone to it, that might have happened there. Alright, this place is actually quite deserted. Ooh. Why would it... See, that's the kind of weird stuff that, like, it doesn't bother me about this game, it just, like, confuses me. Like, why did it show up as two separate entries for 6 and 14? It was just one stash. Like, why not just do 20? It's so strange. Alright! Turrets activated, let's get back to crazy old Barney. Wonder if this will let me drop here. It'll probably be okay. Sure. This whole town is like... just eerily quiet. It's just like super abandoned. Not gonna lie, I'm a tiny bit freaked out. Not like right now in the moment, just imagining going to that witchcraft museum. Like, that could actually be scary. I'm also a wuss. But, you know, it is what it is. And I honestly don't remember how I got in here in the first place. It's probably just the front door. Hey, look, there's one of those wires. It ends right here at the gate. Oh, it probably just provides power to the gate. Okay. Alright, Barney. Don't shoot me. It's just me.
Hey, Barney.
You did it, didn't you? I could hear that sweet, sweet machine gun music all the way down here. You almost caught me and Reba mid-waltz.
Right. Is that it? Will they come back? I'm glad that's over with. Great, now I'm covered in crab guts.
Is that it? Will they come back?
They might, but they'll have something to think about if they do. Now. About that reward. Here's a key to my workshop in the bunker. Reba 2 should be sitting on the table in there. I'd say you earned her. Now, if you'll excuse me, I believe today is earmarked for some target practice. The Salem Volunteer Militia never rests.
Cool. Hey, that's a nice chunk of XP for that. And Dance liked it. Wonder if that's the only quest we've got for this guy.
This area seems to be in disarray. I wonder if this is recent.
He doesn't want to talk anymore. Alright, forget him. Okay, weapons workbench. Here's Reba 2. Can we take anything we want in here? Well, it's not marked as stolen property, so I'm gonna take it. It's all part of the reward. That's the way I see it.
Why are you bothering with that junk?
It's kind of annoying how often they ask me that. It's like, haven't you seen the wonders I've built with all this junk? The giant structures, the amazing weapons, the armor that protects us both. Okay. So here we go, Reba 2.
Yes.
Does 50% more damage against Mire Lurks and Bugs. Well, let's see. It does 103 damage and uses 308 ammo, which I have a fair amount of. Already has a calibrated powerful receiver, a long light barrel, full stock. Looks like it's already pretty pimped out. Let's check it out. Let's compare it to my laser sniper. Which, to be honest with you guys, I've never really loved the feel of. I mean, it does a shitload of damage, but I don't know. It just, like, it doesn't feel powerful when I shoot it. Maybe that's dumb, but I've never liked the way it, like, handles. And this, it does do a lot more damage, though, than Reba. And I never actually got clarification. This has always said that it shoots an additional projectile, but I don't really know what that means. Does that mean that it does double damage? Like it's shooting two shots at everybody that does 158 times two? Or is 158 the total? Like, it doesn't specify, so I have no way of knowing. But let's see what we can do to Reba. It's already got a calibrated powerful. If we put on a 50 receiver, it would do a little bit more damage, but it would also change the ammo type. We could put on a long ported barrel, which would do pretty much nothing, except make it heavier. Well, superior recoil range and sighted accuracy, I guess. That's something. Marksman stock, better aim with scopes, and better recoil. Meh. Large quick eject mag to improve the ammo capacity. We could always put a different kind of scope on it. I kind of like the night vision scopes, honestly. And I don't really see the point in putting a muzzle on a sniper, because I think these all actually make it worse. They reduce the range on it. Which is dumb. Although, maybe a suppressor wouldn't be a bad idea. Range, it doesn't affect the range all that much. That actually probably would be a good idea. So I don't know, I'm conflicted. On one hand, I kind of want to go back to a regular sniper with, like, actual bullets instead of lasers, but on the other hand, it's just not as good as what I currently have. So... yeah. I don't know how I'm gonna proceed. I guess we'll just see. I mean, realistically, if I'm not sucking, then, you know, getting headshots with a sniper should take out most things anyway, so maybe the overall damage doesn't matter all that much. But that could also just be wishful thinking. I don't know.
Excuse me.
Okay, well, it appears that's all we got for Barney. He doesn't seem interested in talking anymore. Let's maybe head outside and see if we can find something to use this thing on. Of course, if I'm going to do that, I should probably actually equip it. It's a pretty nice scope, actually. Hold my breath. Okay, well... let's, let's see. Yeah, there's the Museum of Witchcraft. Let's at least start heading there. I don't rightly know how much progress we'll make on that. But we can at least head in that direction. And I'm again having trouble reading the markers on my indicator. I think it's leading me this way. I think it's the building marker right there. Which I just ran past. Who the hell is it? It's like stopping right on this point. It's weird. I think we should be pretty close to it. Here we go. It's down in this direction. I couldn't remember if it was gonna put on, like, a marker, like one of those blank ones like that, or actually show, like, the building marker. Sandy Coves Convalescent Home. Why is it taking me here? What's my active quest right now? I have no active quests. I wonder why it's bringing me here. And it said something about picking up a key from the front desk. Let me just scroll through these right quick, see if anything catches my eye. No. Oh, it's a miscellaneous. Retrieve the key from the front desk attendant. Okay, well, while we're here, might as well check it out. Using a sniper in an indoor area is a recipe for terribleness. So we'll pull out the shoddy. Front desk attendant, level 7. Okay, so even if he turns hostile, he shouldn't be a problem.
This place would elicit fear in most individuals. Fortunately, my training prevents... but wait, what was that?
Dan's trying to act all big. Whoa. They actually look kind of creepy, like, with the flames in the dark. It's cool.
Welcome to Sandy Cove's Convalescent Home. How may I help you?
This place is still in business, just browsing. Okay, these are all gonna be persuasions, I guess. Well, most of them.
This place is still in business?
But of course! Sandy Cove's Convalescent Home runs in continuous operation.
Whoops, I forgot. It's the opposite. Glad I saved!
I'm checking in. My family filled out the paperwork earlier.
Nice. Oh, that was easy.
Welcome! We'll put you in Gladys's old room. Take the back stair and it's the first door on your left. Have a nice day!
Cool. Yeah, for some reason I thought the darker color one was gonna be the, persuasion check. I don't know. It's like 3 a.m, guys, bear with me. I don't really remember where we got this quest from, or why I'm doing this. Let's see if it updated that. Huh. Okay. I guess that was the only part of the quest. Well, let's go check out the room at least. Maybe there's something interesting in it. Hello, dead person.
I'd just leave this place.
Wonder if there's gonna be like traps or anything set up in this place. Why am I in caution?
Finding a quiet spot in the Commonwealth is a rare occurrence.
Ethel's safe key. I'm actually gonna not pick that up so I can get the XP from picking the lock, but now I know that there's a safe somewhere in here. Trick will be finding it. Let's look more carefully back in this area.
You must be terminated.
That's enough excitement. Whoa. For one day.
Get it, dance! Move, dick! There's action happening. I saw something about a synth.
Ah, more visitors. Welcome to Sandy Cone.
Holy shit! Dude, did they just murder the front desk attendant?
Your stealthy attack was unsuccessful.
Oh. Okay, I don't know where these dudes came from. But they are all about to get blasted on. Jesus. Ooh. There is actually some sick recoil on this thing. Never really noticed that before, until now. Alright. There we go. Mac and cheese, always delicious. And some cram. So what the hell was all this about? These dudes just showed up and started blasting, man. These synths are like freaking creepy too. Front desk attendant has been dealt with. He is no longer part of the equation. Here's a terminal. Okay, no likeness for mask. 3 for bear. Fear.
I'm through.
Lost safe key reminders. If a resident loses their safe key, check in their habitual hiding spot. Oh! Look, it's a little list of where you could find safe keys in here. By her cat bowls, behind his typewriter, beneath her paintbrush, under her fertilizer, under the mounted deer head. Wow, they really lay it all out there for you. Security alert for Gladys. Gladys has escaped 3 times now. I think she just does it to remind us she's still dangerous. I swear that lady has explosives hidden away in her room. Nice. These Mr. Handys are driving me crazy. They consistently fail to check the fake bus stop outside for escapees. At some point, the local police are going to figure out why our residents are wandering the streets. And security door. No idea what I'm opening, but we'll do it. Oh, probably this door back here, huh? Oh, shit. Look at all these. Dude, oh, they all require keys, though. Oh. You bastards. I wanted to pick them all. Ooh, a short syringer rifle. Dude, I've been able to make ammo for this gun for the longest time, and I never had the gun. But now I do. Craft ammo for the syringer at a chemistry station. That's awesome. Massachusetts Surgical Journal.
Hell yeah.
permanently inflict plus 2% limb damage. That's a good pickup. I like this area. I'm glad I came in here. It's creeping me out a little bit, but there's also lots of good stuff. Okay, this was the security door that opened. Chemistry station. Let's take a look-see and see what we can make. Syringe or ammo. Bleed out syringe does 30 points of damage over 10 seconds to target. We can make mind cloud syringe. Target believes the player has vanished and has a reduced chance to detect you for 30 seconds. Oh, that's kind of nice. Aid you in your stealth. There is a shitload of this ammo, dude. Look at all this stuff. Antifreeze bottles, dirty water, lead, stingwing, barb. I mean, they all require all kinds of different stuff. Bloatfly glands. Pencils. That would be why I've been picking up pencils this whole game. I was wondering about that. Reduces target's damage resistance by 25% for 2 minutes. That would be fantastic for boss fights. Yo, I'm gonna have to start carrying this. That's so much, like, so much stuff to deal with. I can't even handle it right now. Let's make some of these buff tats. Use up the stuff I got. I don't do this very often, but I should start. We'll just make all this stuff up so I have it. Carrots. Still appear to be good.
Why is it so quiet in here? I don't like this.
I don't know, man. There's some weird stuff happening in this place. I find it odd that those synths just showed up, like, right as I did. They must have been hanging out in here. And then they got, like, triggered when I came in somehow. I don't know why they just attacked the front desk attendant like that. This appears to be some kind of, like, lounge area for the old people. They all died drinking and playing games. There are much worse ways to go out. Mutated fern flower. Interesting. This whole building's actually a little bigger than I thought it would be. We still got more to explore back here, and then we have the whole upstairs area. With the keys for the safes and all that shit. Yeah, this is gonna take a while to go through all this stuff. Sandy Cove's attendant. Man, they ice all these dudes, too. Cold-blooded, man. Cold-blooded.
These robots are fishing rod. Ignoring the fact that their charges have passed away. They must have a fault in their programming.
Well, they're not ignoring shit now. Because they're dead. Oh, Sea Captain's hat. Sure, let's take that. Mortimer's safe key.
Excellent.
Nice. There's one of them at least. Okay, I'll tell you what, here's the plan, guys. We will take this Mortimer's key and we will go see what's in the safe. And then we will probably wrap up this video. I think I'll refer to the terminal and just make a list for the next video so I can very quickly and easily search out the rest of these keys. That way we don't waste a ton of time in a video just running around like idiots. Because I want to show you everything that's in there, and I know that you want to see it, but I want to do it in the most efficient way possible. I'm sure you all agree. Let me just double check that I got Oh shit, one of them's still alive.
Sir?
Nice. No, there's still a couple of rooms back here that I didn't even get to. Oh, Edward's key.
Yes.
Alright. I really should have taken that first key I found, but I didn't know it was going to be like this. I didn't want that burn book. Ooh, overdue book. Sweet. Another overdue
this
book.
This looks like a good place to rest.
I remember one of them was under a deer head. Oh, would this be it? That's a painting of a moose head. That's not going to be the same thing. I'm going to take those glasses too. Can I look at that paper? No. I better start taking every pencil I find. For my syringer. I know this video is going later than I said it was going to. That's what this game does, man. It sucks me in. I never want to stop playing. Okay, and this goes upstairs. It probably wraps around up there. Let's go hit these safes. I think this is a shorter way this way. Or did I get turned around? There's an elevator. I don't think I was in this room yet. A lot of the stuff I've been wanting to make also takes dirty water. Which I pretty much always, like, as soon as I got the water, I would purify it. I gotta stop doing that. It's dumb that a lot of the stuff you can't make with clean water. Like, you'd think it would just be better that way. But no, it wants dirty water. It wants dirty post-apocalypse shit water. Which I cannot identify with. But whatever. It seems like a place that would have a key. Yellow trench coat. Charisma and endurance. That sounds cool. I don't think I have anything like that. So I'm gonna take it. Margaret's safe key. I figured there'd be one in here somewhere. So we've actually made pretty good progress. We already have three of them. Which is great. And I think I've hit most areas down here now. Goes up, that goes up, this leads back into the play area, there's a kitchen back here, this hallway comes out, good god this place is massive! I think I was back here, this wraps around, and I'm lost again.
Why is it so quiet in here?
Okay, here we go. This is the spot I was looking for. Okay. Four psychos. This old dude was hanging on to drugs for some reason. More drugs. Are these the drugs that they gave them to keep them, like, docile?
Can't pick this.
I was kind of hoping it would be like their riches, like their life savings.
Don't have the key.
Or their valuables, you know, like something. But drugs are good too, you know, I use them occasionally. I probably already have more than I could ever use in this game, but we'll stick with the plan anyway, because, you know, some of these other safes might even have more stuff. You know, you never know. You just don't know until you try. So anyways, guys, I am going to end this here. Oh, there's a book return terminal here. Awesome. Give me a second. Return them books. I've got... how many tokens? I have 25 tokens. So here we can get a hairbrush, a magnifying glass, a new toy truck, chalk, or bubblegum. That stuff all sucks. I was hoping this terminal would have a magazine or something else good, but it doesn't. Oh well. At least now I know. Okay, yeah, so, gonna end the video. Like I said, we'll pick up here next time, get the rest of them keys, and check out the rest of these safes. What is that? Ooh, a silver pocket watch.
Feeling a bit nostalgic?
And a silver locket. Okay. Yes. All right, we're good. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch y'all in the next video. Have a good one. I'll see you.